Live. You're live.
Oh, hey. All right. Hi, everybody. How's it going? Dan Shinder here. I'm Drum Talk TV.
And 1 day old. Yesterday was our 8th year anniversary. I did a little celebration. I'll be doing a few more this month. But today is a special celebration of the life, music, and lyrics of Neil Peart, who passed away 1 year ago today, January 7th. So first of all, tell me where you're watching from. I'm in Globe, Arizona. Where is that? We're like 100 miles east of Phoenix, up in the mountains a bit. I'd love to know where you're watching from. Feel free to share stories of your favorite album, your favorite song. How many times did you see them? What was your favorite tour? You know, all that kind of stuff. And I'll do my best to adjust. I'm thinking of adjusting that camera. I'll do my best to address those. I'm going to turn this camera slightly. Not that it matters that much. But I appreciate you joining me for this. And I have to say, I'm not Neil Peart. I don't plan to try and fool you and make it seem like I can play like Neil Peart. But Neil and the music of Rush and his lyrics were influences on my musical sensibilities. I saw them 14, 16 times, maybe something like that. The first year in 1978, Jonathan Velez right here in Globe, Arizona. Enja, what do you think of that? And he says, hi, Dan and Enja. Hello, Brian Cahoon. Thanks for joining us. I just want you to enjoy the music with me. I'll do my best. I will flub up, and that's okay because I'm not Neil Peart, so that's okay. I've seen Neil flub up, but there are no mistakes in music, only new discoveries. So give a shout-out to your favorite song, your favorite album, your favorite tour, your favorite live album, your favorite bootleg, your favorite studio song, your favorite lyrics, your favorite drum part, drum fill, drum intro, drum finale, whatever. Let's just celebrate the music. And this might get muted. Darn it, I meant to put something in the post. I'll have to do it after. It might get muted on and off from time to time, not while you're watching it live, but if you're watching it on the archive, and I will fix that as quickly as soon as possible. I have a simple form to fill out to do that. So let's just get into it, okay? And I'll check comments after this first piece. Ray Childs, hey, I hope you and your wife are well. I'm going to start out with something that's on the first Rush album I bought, not the first one I heard. So here's how I discovered Rush. I was 14, so that was 1977. Yeah. And a friend of mine brought over 2112. And like most people that heard that for the first time, especially if they didn't hear Rush before, my mouth dropped open. Side one, 2112. Huh. How apropos that song seems in these times right now, but we won't get into that. And I'm going to get into comments in just a moment. Anyways, Bruce was a keyboard player, brought over 2112, 1 year older than me. I was 14, he was 15. Blew my mind! But like most album experiences for me, the first album I bought was live. So that was the first live album, All the World's a Stage. I figure it's a great way to get a cross-section of the band's music up to that time, and plus hear them with no overdubs, and back then, not even sequencers or anything like that. And I loved the album, And I saw them 2 years later, 1 year later, in 1978. I saw them twice on the Hemispheres tour. Amazing. So I'm going to play some of 2112. Sorry, just looking at some stuff here. Carissa Steele, Maurizio Russo, hola. Saw them 10 times, and my most memorable was the last one, R40 Tour. My favorite drum track by him is Hemispheres. Me too. Maybe I'll play that. Maybe. And that's from Aldo Guerra Guajardo. I hope I got that right. All right, let's just lay into it, and I will be checking comments. Here we go. Let me know how the sound is. We're using our new version of our old multi-camera shoot system, so we'll see how that goes. Hopefully the Wi-Fi will hold up. I'll apologize now if it gets sticky, but give us feedback. Ah, no pun intended. And here we go, whoops, with some 2112. See if I remember it. I only heard this version for part of my warm-up. Put my glasses somewhere. Did anyone see him on this tour? I think on the All the World's a Stage tour, the 2112 tour, they opened for UFO. They opened for Ted Nugent. This might have been one of the tours they opened for Kiss as well. When I saw them, they were the headliner. Here we go.
Thank you.
in there. So, hey, that's always fun, right? Start out with like one of the hardest songs on the list that you haven't played in a long time. But how can you not play 2112, right? If you're going to do a tribute to Neil Peart, whether you can play it or not. So let me check comments and let me see what this other noise is coming out. Oh, I know what it is. Okay. So how's everyone doing? If you're joining us late, it's a little tribute to Neil Peart on the anniversary of his passing. I still can't believe that. What a shock. And again, yeah, Marcel Chris Dubé points out something very interesting. I wonder how many are at home drumming along with this. Yeah, because this is one of the most popular air drumming songs, right? Probably this, In the Air Tonight, Highway Star, Burn, and even Geddy Lee air drums to this part, right? Dun, 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 dun. Even Geddy does that, so... yeah, that's a great question. And hopefully you're air drumming to it a lot better than I'm actually playing. My first concert ever was Hemispheres with Pat Travers at the Swing in California. Milt, I was there. I saw them the night or two before in Long Beach and then had to go see them again. What you missed, though, was their pyrotechnics because they couldn't do that at the Swing. And in fact, coincidentally, when I saw them at Long Beach the night or two before, the flash pot for that song that went off on Getty's side caught the skirt of the front of the lighting rig on fire, and Getty was like singing a line and then stepping it back and little pieces of material. Crew came out, kept an eye on it, but it worked out to be okay. So I got some other songs on the list. Ray Childs is my grandson, is on here now. Matthew Smith, up and rising drummer at 15. That's awesome. Send in a video, drumtalktv.com, video submissions button at the top, and there's a whole section for that. Action Stage Left changed my life, says Omar. Nice. Marcel also says, hi, I heard Tom Sawyer, then later would air drum to Power Windows, one of my favorite, and I think most difficult Rush albums to play drums on, but didn't realize I was on the right drum and on the beat. Was told that I should play drums, and the rest is history. Wow, that's really cool. That's awesome. A lot of great stuff here. Thanks. Pick songs, and if they're on the set list I have, I will play them. I'm going to pick one now. This is one of my favorites. This is a great song here. This is from Moving Pictures, 1980 or 81, I think 80. This is a great song. The Camera Eye from Moving Pictures. I love everything about this song. Another good one to air drum to. And chime in. Tell us where you're watching from. Favorite album. What role Neil's music and lyrics played in your life. I'll look over here. And your favorite album. Did you see them? Favorite tour. Anything you want. Favorite guitar solo by Alex. One of mine is the first one in Hemispheres. I love this one too. It's quite different. I'll turn it up in a moment. This is really a great song. The Camera Eye. I thought I'd never be able to play it. And you know what? I still can't. So there you go. I remember going out at lunch and getting the album on vinyl. When I was in 10th grade, 11th maybe? We'll be right back. camera eye. Let's see if anyone has any suggestions while I take a sip of water, catch my breath. I'll check comments. My wife is a Rush fan. Turn the camera on yourself. Hell no, she says. My wife is so beautiful. Hell no, she says to the camera, though. That was called the camera eye. That's why. Yeah, see what I did there? I'm alone here? Okay. All right. Any suggestions? Questions? Enja says, my wife's name is Enja, for those of you who don't know, N-J-A. Enja says, can you ask them how the picture and the sound is? Not my playing, just the picture and the sound, okay? Okay. I know my wife probably has a suggestion, and I probably know what it is. She's seen Rush how many times? Twice? Three? Three times? Well, three times. All with me? Oh, yes. Got the evil eye. Oh, the weapon. Wow, I haven't heard that in so long. Alberto, thank you. Marcel, let me think about that one. I might have to save that. Ooh, anything from Clockwork Angels Tour. Brian, I have something that I will take a ugly stab at. Thank you for that. Raymond Orange Nutter. Why would your folks name you that? Raymond Orange Nutter. What the hell's up with Raymond? Raymond, always glad to hear you. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. Correction from Mr. Steven Shinder. Moving Pictures came out in 1981. Thanks, Steve-O. Marcel also says, Dan, think you can keep up with the spirit of Rush and music alive. Oh, thank you, as we all have Rush within us. There's so many musicians and music fans that were influenced by Rush. Thank you. I saw the same tour, San Francisco, Cal Palace, also my first concert. Oh, really? That's awesome, Eddie. My first concert ever was Hemispheres of Power. Okay, I read that already. Okay, so I'm going to play something from the Clockwork Angels tour, and then I'll take a suggestion from my wife, and then I'll look at some more. So let me cue that song up. Oh, if you guys only knew what was playing right now. Okay. This one I tried during the sound check, to be honest with you, just a little bit of it. This recording's kind of mushy, actually, but I'll do my best. It's not an excuse. It just is what it is, and that's what it is. Here we go with Caravan. I'll come in after the drums burst in. Less chance of it getting muted. Thanks again for joining me. Love my Drum Talk TV fans. You're what makes all this hard work so worth it. 8 years yesterday of Drum Talk TV.
I'm
know if anyone's even still watching after that one. Let's see here. Let me pause this so I can get back to you and put my glasses on so I can see what the heck's happening. So that was my ugly attempt at Caravan on the Clockwork Angels album and tour, suggested by Brian Cahoon. Thank you so much. Hey, Joel Hickman, thanks for joining us. Appreciate it so much. How about something off the Presto album? The very last piece was suggested yesterday by my son, Steven, who's on board with us, our associate producer, and does a lot of other behind-the-scenes stuff for Drum Talk TV. Thank you, Steve. Steve suggested something off of Presto. That'll be the last piece I play, so hang in there. It's pretty fitting, too. Oh, Lisa Ramos. Lisa Ramos. Lisa, Engine, and I. What is that? Oh, wow. The cat is trying to get in. There's a cat trying to get in here with all this noise. Lisa Ramos, Engine, and I are at about 90% raw foods now. So changed my life. My blotches are gone. No more blotches on my arm, my body. It's a health thing, folks. Lisa Ramos is our raw food advocate, her and her husband, Rigo. Let's see what else is going on here. Thank you, everybody. Okay, so let's go to, oh, Marcel also says, looks like I need to catch up on, as I might have been so busy with the creations that I think that I missed a few albums, by the way. Sounds great. Keep it up. Thank you so much. That means so much to me. Brian Cahoon mentions a song that I will be playing. In fact, Enja, do you have a request, Mrs. Shinder?
My usual one.
Your usual one, which is? Enja wants me to play a Far Cry. She loves that song. So, here we go. The reason why, if I remember right, is because... I'm trying to find it now. Sorry, where'd it go? There it is. Why? I forgot. The murals? Oh, okay. So when I was working in Australia for quite a while, we lived in Las Vegas. While I was living in Australia, Angela was still in Vegas where we're living, and she's the first, I could say it, right? The first woman muralist and black muralist for the city of Las Vegas, and she did a lot of beautification projects behind the Stratosphere. So she was missing me, and that album came out, Snakes and Arrows, and A Far Cry, she listened to over and over and over while she painted these giant murals wrapping apartment buildings and was missing me. So A Far Cry kind of has that sort of connotation. So that's for my wife, Angela, right after this commercial. Let's see if I remember this one.
All right, here we go with A Far Cry. We'll be right back.
microphone. My wife's over there dancing, hitting all the off cues. All right, that was a far cry. My wife's favorite Rush song? Pretty close. What else? What else? Sing a part of it. Hemispheres. All right. Thanks for putting up with this. I'm not Neil Peart. I know I can't play like Neil Peart, but I love Neil's lyrics, his music, his drumming, the music of Rush, and we're paying tribute to Neil on the one-year anniversary of his passing. Luke Bierski is on board. Hey. Luke Bierski in Singapore by way of NZ, Tasmania, sorry. How you doing? We miss you. Can't wait to get out there and see you again. Lamont Wells. Wow, thank you. What a compliment. You sound like Neil Peart. Thank you so much. I'm doing my best. And Brian is right. Snakes and Arrows is good, full of goodies. Yeah, I won't play this song, but I love this intro. But I won't play the song, but I love this intro. Gotta do it. And this is the perfect china to do it with. Let's see if I remember. It's a great sing-along song when you're on a bus ride. Let's see. Thank you guys and girls so much. So many odd rhythms and timings in the beginning. Yeah. Thank you. Okay, how about, you know, the Presto tour is one of the few tours I miss. So I don't know the medley, and as much as I'm into their bootlegs, I don't remember that. So, thanks, everyone. I'm going to look at my list. Oh, it's over here. How about we do one of my favorites. Can we do one of my favorites? I mean, they're all my favorites. I said that camera I was on my, but this is one of my favorites to play, and it's called Middletown Dreams. I freaking love this song. All right. Let's see if I can hang in there a little more for a few more. Oh. Here. All right, we're just waiting for the commercial. Thank you. actually kind of thought I know what I was doing there until like the very, very end. Oh, I love that song. There's something, you know, sometimes there's just something about a song you can't even always put your finger on it, but it just does something for you. That's one of them. And I think some of it is, let's see if you can hear me like this. Let me pause that. It's like in the beginning, how's it going? Store closed early. I just love that. And then when it's going into the... And then right before the chorus, it sort of opens up. I don't know if I'm even explaining it right. Maybe that's not even the same song. No, I'm kidding. I just love the dynamics, I guess, and all the play with the hi-hat, doing different things and getting different sounds and all that stuff. Let me see... Marcel says, as to MTD, PM me a message. What's MTD? I will PM you, but what's MTD? Limelight? maybe. Okay, how about any other requests? I'll play, what time is it? I can play a little more. I'll play maybe a couple more, okay? And then the finale. Two more than the finale? Okay. So how about, I'm looking at my playlist that my son Steve put together. By the way, when this is done, Steven Shinder, put this in the comments and pin it as a pinned comment. The link to your tribute to Neil Peart on the Drum Talk TV website. You know, Neil gets a lot of credit for his drumming, of course, but his lyrics are amazing. And my son Steve wrote a whole thing that has something maybe from almost every album about his lyrics. It's really cool, and there's some great photos there as well. So Steve will put that link in there for you to check out after. Okay, so I'll throw out some songs. YYZ, now you guys don't want to hear that. YYZ, Xanadu, Available Light is going to be last. So two other songs. I'll do YYZ, then I'll look for one more suggestion, then Available Light, excuse me. Got the hiccups, which reminds me I should take a drink of water. 1 second, please. All right. Everyone having fun, I hope. I hope I'm not, like, ruining this or anything. I admit, I'm a little self-conscious because yesterday was the first time I played full on in quite a while. Delay here, so I'll play YYZ and then I'll see what's going on. All right. That could be a swing song, right? Almost there. It's a commercial. Oh. I'll jump in. We'll be right back. timpani drums. All right. What? Oh, hey. She's telling me that camera. YYZ. What a fun song to play. And Marcel et al, everybody. I guess that would be another big air drumming song, right? All right. She's going to let me play one more before the finale. I've already given the finale. How about, actually, let me rewind. Excuse me. Oh, Marcel, you are a bad boy. Marcel says, La Villa Strangiato. If I get a second to that motion, I'll play La Villa Strangiato. And I'm going to get another water real quick. So I'll be. Can you talk to them while I just get a water over there real quick? Just tell them about the first time you saw them or whatever. So meet my wife. For those of you who haven't met her, she's not going to come on camera, but she has a beautiful, beautiful voice. She used to have a phone job. Oh, just kidding.
Oh, good Lord. What am I doing? Wait.
Everyone and
hello, everyone, and what are you up to?
A rush experience,
how about
yeah,
the first? Oh, good Lord. How about the first time you took me to a concert? That would be good.
Yeah.
Yeah, he is. That's right. We had so much fun, too. That was a lot of fun. And hanging out together. And, I don't know. He was living in Vegas.
Know.
I don't remember anything. Was it the one with the chickens? With the rotisserie chicken? Was that the first one?
Oh, the first Rush concert. I thought you meant the first concert.
No, first Rush concert.
It
was it? Was it the rotisserie chickens?
That was Sticks and Arrows.
Okay. Well, anyway, you guys know what I'm talking about. So it was fun. But it was really, really cool. That's the first time I got really exposed to that kind of music. And, it was pretty awesome. So much to the point that that was the first time I really got a chance to see Dan and his concert element. Are you going to take this back, aren't you?
Oh, yeah.
How you doing?
Yeah,
I'm just listening to your story like I always do. Except this time I didn't put on the international transatlantic jet flight neck thing to listen to your story. All right, so did I get a second to that motion? I don't care who you are, to follow Neil like this is awesome to watch. I'm almost ready to play Rush. And this gives me a lot of insight. Matthew, that's so cool. You're ready. Just play it. Don't worry about making mistakes or playing it exactly. I'm certainly not. And I've been playing Rush music since 1977. And you can see I don't have it down. So just do it. It'll stretch your boundaries. It'll bring new muscle memory, you know, to you. Okay, so I got a second. All right, we're going to do La Villa Strangiato. I'm going to let the intro play while I look at some more comments. And there's a delay. So what I see on the screen is like a minute behind or so, maybe. So, but I am going to play La Villa. Their first instrumental, in case you don't know, La Villa Strangiato means basically hooray for the strange. And it's broken down into a few different movements that all represent different aspects of Alex Lifeson's chronic bad dreams. The first movement is Buenas Noches, Mein Freunds, and that's the Spanish guitar part in the beginning, and then it goes into To Sleep, Perchance, to Dream. Then it goes into the Strangiato theme. Then it goes into a Lyrics in Wonderland. Lyrixed is Alex Lifeson's nickname. They all three have each nicknames for each other. Monsters is right after that, which you will recognize from the Bugs Bunny cartoon. Bum, 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 da, 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 da. And then we've got after that, Danforth and Pape. And then Waltz of the Shreves. Waltz of the Shreves is the one that goes like this. I love this section. It goes. When I first heard that, and our band said, yeah, let's learn that and play it. I'm like, what? I mean, I was already playing like crazy music, ELP and stuff, but for some reason I heard that beat, and I thought I'd never get it. I got it on like the third try.
And listen for like the Jimmy Page lick that Alex does in that part. Anyways, what's after that? We've got The Waltz of the Shreves. Oh, Never Turn Your Back on a Monster. Monsters Reprise, Sharon Giotto Reprise, and then A Farewell to Things, which is a play on words of their previous album. So let's see. Oops, it started. Here we go.
Thank you.
jeez, that song is such a workout. I can't believe I played that when I was 15, 1978 when that came out. And I think I may have played it a lot better then because I was playing all the time. Now I have a job. I run Drum Talk TV. I have a social media marketing company. Don't have nearly as much time to play. So I'm going to check comments, and then I'm going to do the encore, which was chosen by my son, Steven, yesterday. And I've actually never played this song. So this will be interesting, and it's a beautiful song. It's probably one of the very few that has a ballad-esque touch to it. I'll get into it in a moment. I'm going to take a drink of water, let the comments catch up a little bit, and thank you, everybody, for being so interactive and everything. I really appreciate it. Share this with your friends, please, whether you're seeing it live or seeing it on the archive. Not for a dig me factor. I'm 57 years old. I'm very comfortable in my skin. It's not about watching me play. It's about just paying tribute to the influence of Rush and Neil's music and Neil's lyrics. And if you know someone that would appreciate that and be inspired, like some of you have mentioned, to play this stuff or play more or learn new things or stretch your musical boundaries, please share it. That's why we do Drum Talk TV. Water. Who's got the water? We're about at the end of of the stickiness. Okay, I'm gonna read some comments while the video catches up, and then I'm gonna play Available Light. So let's see. Marcel Lightning Dubé says, "I used to think that Alex Lifeson was such an underrated player until I heard that Paul Gilbert and John Petrucci of Dream Theater were influenced by him." Absolutely. Sounded awesome until the video stopped. Oh, sorry, huh? I don't know why the video stopped. I'm still seeing it. Yeah, that part would get to me at times too. That little jazz thing with the shots. Yeah. Okay, cool. Yeah, I don't know what's up with the video. It looks okay on this end. It could be your internet provider, it could be us, who knows. Yeah, and just hiding in the shadows for sure. Gabriel Scott says, "Thank you for doing this. It means so much. Neil was the reason I even started playing drums. My inspiration, Gabriel, that's awesome." Why don't you all say real quickly where you're watching from? I would love that. Matthew Todd Nelson, you thought we wouldn't find you here. Matthew says, "It's hard to finish the show because I want to go play." Sing this song, I'm so glad. And that's why we post other people playing. This is why I play. This is why I interview artists. Gavin Harrison is tomorrow. Gavin Harrison's tomorrow already, Friday, 1 o'clock Mountain Standard Time in the U.S. Cindy Blackman next Wednesday at the same time. Sign up for the newsletter. Check out Stephen's, not now, check out Stephen's tribute to Neil Peart as a lyricist. It's on our website, but Steve put the link in there and pinned it. I hope you did that, Steve. I'll scroll back down, look at some others. Now I see why you called me a bad boy. This is such a crazy song. It really is, and thank you. I very more often play things that I haven't played in a long time, or this next song I've never played before. It's not like I've been shedding, air drumming, listening to it over and over and over. I didn't even hear a whole thing once last night. Steve suggested it. I put it on. I listened to most of it, and I thought, I'll figure it out. Well, you're going to watch me figure it out or not. So there, it's important to not get hung up on. It's important to just play. Just play. You will get better the more you play. So just play. Be mindful of what you're playing, how you're playing, what you did right. Record yourself. But, you know, like I said, I'm not worried about being judged or what people think. I really could not care less. I play for myself, and that's what every musician should always do first. Play for yourself. You got to put yourself out there. Stumble around a little bit. Alonzo, hi Alonzo. He says, "I think the middle section of the Free Will, oh yeah, is very challenging." Do Sorry. I know that note for note on guitar, I just can't play it well at all. And another thing. Learn how every instrument goes. Even if you don't play that instrument, just be able to sing every note of every instrument of every song you play so you understand the language, the conversation, the dialect, the twists and turns. It's a roadmap to know what's ahead. Just like when you drive somewhere familiar, you know what's coming up. You know, okay, I got to watch out for that light in case it turns yellow or red. Oh, there's a crosswalk. Oh, I know there's always a crossing guard there. Oh, this is where the train is. Is there a train? No, good, let me keep going. You know, it's the same thing. Learn every note of every thing you play. Belleville, Ontario, Canada. A hoser. All right, nice. It's all about the learning factor. You're right. All right, here we go with available light. Let me just get situated. Here we go. I've never played this. Getty on piano. All the wind can carry. Oh, sing it if you know it. Thank you. to kind of cap off and put a period at the end of the conversation we had right before I played that about learning the other instruments, like I said, I haven't played that song ever, and I haven't heard it in forever, except for like some of it last night. And I never would have been able to even fake my way through it like I just did if I didn't know how it went. So there's a difference between listening to music and learning it. And you don't have to play it to learn it. You don't have to play guitar to learn the guitar solo. You don't have to play keyboards to learn, you know, the riffs and the rhythms and the twists and the turns and the dynamics and everything. But because I know all that, it helped me fake my way through it better than if someone just suggested a song that I've never really learned. Maybe I've heard it, and there's plenty of those songs, believe me. I would never even attempt to play it because I don't want to just play along to something I don't know. I don't know where the breaks are. You know what I mean? Especially with a song like Rush. But sometimes people are suggesting Metallica and, you know, different things. And I love Metallica, but I don't know any of the music. I can hear them and go, oh, that's Metallica. Maybe I don't know the name of the song. Maybe I do. But I never learned any of it. So your ears are the most valuable part of being a musician. Your ears connecting with your mind and learning how all those instruments go. I'll never forget, I almost fell over when a drummer told me, yeah, I'm not a lyrics guy. I don't know the words to any of the songs I played. And like, it's the other instrument. There's okay, just as an example, let's take, yes, there's drums, there's bass, there's guitar, there's keyboards, and there's vocals. That's a freaking instrument. How do you not learn that part and play the music to whatever it is? And even in his case, especially your own band's music. You don't know the words? Get out of here. I just think that's crazy. There's Stephen's tribute to Neil Peart, delving into his lyrical prowess, as Steve says in the article, and it's really nice. I encourage you to check it out. Belleville means beautiful city. In French, I'm guessing, Marcel. Oui, oui, oui. Comment allez-vous? Très bien. So I want to thank Stephen for helping me put the playlist together and just sharing and stuff. If you see me sharing it, it's because he's in my account. I'm not sharing it. I'm doing this live. This is really live, unless you're watching on the archive. And I want to thank my lovely, amazing wife. I really wish you'd get back on camera someday. Well, yeah, I used to be on camera. What's the deal? What's happening? What's going on? She says she's not ready for that today. My beautiful wife, Enja, was a tremendous help. Working the switcher, switching the cameras and all that stuff, doing the transitions and the graphics in the beginning and all that. I want to thank Switcher Studio. That's the software we're using for this. Go to switcherstudio.com or hit me up personally or message us through the website, and I'll hook you up with our guy there, Mark. And I want to thank Ahead Drumsticks and Accessories. I love these sticks. This is my third pair in 7 years, maybe eight now. They just don't break. They don't leave splinters everywhere. I also want to thank Remo. I've had these heads on here. Now, don't laugh, and you especially won't laugh when I tell you the story about the heads before these. I've had these on here for a year and 2 months, I think, and I think they still sound wonderful. I have no bottom heads. I don't use dampening, old school. I love drums to sound like an instrument, have tone, have notes. So they're a year and 2 months old. Some of you might be freaking out. What? That's too long. Well, they still sound fine. I had Remo pinstripes on this kit, and there's three or four of the drums not set up, for over 15 years. In fact, what am I saying? About 19 years, the same heads. I never changed them. I just didn't feel they needed it. But I love these, so thank you, Bob, over at Remo. And I want to thank Rob Wallace at Hudson Music. Shoot over to the Hudson Music Facebook page. We posted one of the same tributes they did, but there's one that is unique to them. I think we shared it to our page, but check out Hudson Music Facebook page. Check out hudsonmusic.com. Beautiful tribute that Rob Wallace did. He knew Neil for over 30 years. And thank you for following what we do. The newsletter comes out this weekend, I think. So sign up for the newsletter. There's a sign-up button on the Facebook page. Trying to think of where else it's in a lot of the posts that we put up. So sign up for the newsletter. You'll find out about interviews coming up. I'm not sure what's going on with event coverage this year or documentaries, but I've got a lot of great guests lined up and a lot more on my whiteboard, starting with Gavin Harrison tomorrow. First one of the year, Cindy Blackman next Wednesday. Very excited about that. and thank you for following what we do. And we'll see you soon, very soon. I'm going to get back to doing these. Thanks. Stay well.